Hi! Welcome to another supercharged lesson in computer skills with me! What's my name again? Mia, who am I? Oh, right, I'm Caroline. Usually your brain stores important things like your address or your favorite food in its long-term memory, so you'll remember it as long as possible. But it seems like my brain accidentally stored my name in short-term memory, which only lasts a few seconds before it gets deleted. Silly brain. Computers work the same way. In the last lesson, you learned how a computer's short-term memory, its RAM, helps the CPU do calculations, but doesn't save the data once the CPU is done using it. But computers also have long-term memory so that you can save documents, games, photos, and music on them for days or months or even years. This long-term data storage comes in a lot of different forms. In this lesson, you'll learn about the uses, benefits, and drawbacks of each form. By the end of this lesson, you will be able to identify different data storage devices and explain how they work, and compare the benefits and drawbacks of internal data storage devices. Let's get into it. In our last lesson on the motherboard, you learned that one important component of a computer's motherboard is the random access memory, or RAM. RAM gives the CPU a place to write its work down while it does calculations, but once it's finished with the calculations, it erases everything from the RAM so it can reuse it for new calculations. Computers can do millions or even billions of these calculations every second. Is your computer completely erasing its memory millions of times every second? No, of course not. If it were, you'd never be able to save anything. Computers as we know them couldn't exist. So if computers aren't storing their data on the RAM, what are they using? The most common data storage device in modern computers is the hard disk drive, also known as an HDD. You'll also commonly hear it called a hard drive. Hard disk drives store your data on, well, hard disks, which are called platters. These platters have billions of magnetic pockets on their surface, which can each be magnetized in one of two directions, which the computer can then interpret as binary code. This arm swings back and forth while the platters spin. Its tip can read the magnetic binary code and even change it in order to save new data. Since it can be used to both read the data on the platter as well as write new data on it, we call the tip of the arm a read-write head. HDDs can store more data than most other storage devices. Plus, they're super cheap. The drawback is that they are mechanical devices with moving parts, which means they're slower than electronic storage, they can wear out over time, and they eat up a ton of power. Luckily, there's another option! Solid-state drives, or SSDs, have no moving parts. They exist as one solid piece, hence the name solid-state. Instead of using magnetism, SSDs store data electronically on computer chips. Without all the moving parts of HDDs, SSDs allow the computer to read and write data at faster speeds. They're much less power-hungry, and they take up a lot less room. Unfortunately, solid-state drives can't store as much data as hard disk drives can. Plus, since solid-state drives are a more recent technology, they're also a lot more expensive. Many computers being manufactured today are being made with SSDs built in rather than the old HDDs, so they're way faster but can't hold as much data. Some people don't want to choose between high speed and large storage capacity, so solid-state hybrid drives, SSHDs, were developed. For the most part, they look and operate just like regular hard disk drives, but if you use a program or file frequently, it will save that data to the solid-state portion instead, so the data you need the most will be lightning fast. Hybrid drives get the capacity of hard drives and the speed of solid-state drives, and the cost is in the middle of the two. Hybrid drives do have one major drawback, though. Since they are made of two different technologies smushed together, if either the hard disk or solid state part malfunctions, the entire drive has to be replaced. And you may lose all of your data. Computers typically include a hard disk drive, solid state drive, or hybrid drive inside, which we refer to as internal data storage. But there are also external data storage devices, which you can connect on the outside of your computer for additional storage. For instance, if your computer's internal storage is full, you can purchase an external hard drive, solid state drive, or hybrid drive and plug it into one of your computer's ports. External drives aren't nearly as fast as internal drives, but if your storage is full, extra space is extra space. The electronic computer chip technology used in SSDs is actually found in a lot of external storage devices too. It's called flash storage because these computer chips can be used to electronically store and read data in a flash. One form of flash storage you may be familiar with is the flash drive, also known as a thumb drive, a pen drive, a memory stick, or a lot of other names. No matter what you call them or what they look like, they work the same way. You plug the drive into a USB port on your computer, wait for it to connect, and now you can save some of your data on the flash drive so you have more room for other things on your internal data storage. SD and micro SD cards also use flash storage and are used just like flash drives, except that they fit into different ports. Some computers do have slots for SD and micro SD cards, but these types of flash storage are most commonly used in smaller devices like phones and handheld gaming systems. Another type of data storage you might be familiar with is optical storage. You've probably seen optical storage before. CDs, DVDs, Blu-ray discs, and game discs are all forms of optical data storage. With optical storage, data is stored on disks using microscopic patterns of either indentations or light and dark spots. When an optical disk is put inside a machine that can read it, a laser is pointed at the disk. As the disk spins, the indentation patterns on it cause the laser to reflect in different ways, which the machine reads and interprets, then outputs as audio or video. These days, optical storage is mainly used for music, movies, and games. Even in an age where we can get most of these things directly from the internet through streaming services, some people still prefer the feeling of holding a physical disk. Oh, that explains why I forgot my name earlier. My long-term memory is full. But I'm not a computer, so I can't just plug in more memory. Let's see if there's anything I can delete. Since my mom got a new phone, I guess I don't need her old phone number anymore. There we go. Now I have enough space for my name. The next and final lesson in this unit is the wrap-up. You'll have a chance to review all the information from this unit, quiz yourself with practice questions, then take an assessment to receive a final grade for this unit. Then you'll be ready to move on to the next unit, where you'll learn the ins and outs of actually using and navigating computers. As always, remember, your brain is the smartest computer, so keep it charged and never stop updating it. Good luck on your assessment, and I'll see you next time.